Julius Robert Oppenheimer, the genius behind the atomic bomb. Part 1, A Brilliant Mind Awakens. In the crisp spring of April 1904, in the bustling city of New York, Julius Robert Oppenheimer was born to a wealthy German-Jewish immigrant family. He would grow up to become one of the most influential scientists of the 20th century. From an early age, Robert, as he was often called, displayed an insatiable curiosity and a prodigious intellect. His parents, Julius S. Oppenheimer and Ella Friedman, recognized his exceptional talents and provided him with every opportunity to nurture his burgeoning scientific curiosity. As a child, Robert was deeply fascinated by the natural world. His early years were spent exploring the rich flora and fauna of the New York countryside, where his family owned a summer home. He collected insects, observed birds, and meticulously documented his findings in notebooks. This early love for observation and discovery would shape his future as a scientist. Robert's educational journey began at the Ethical Culture School in New York City, where he was exposed to a progressive and intellectually stimulating environment. His teachers quickly recognized his exceptional aptitude for mathematics and science. It was here that his fascination with physics began to take root, thanks to a charismatic science teacher who ignited his passion for the subject. Part 2, A Scholar's Odyssey. Oppenheimer's academic journey took him to Harvard University, where he pursued a degree in chemistry with a strong inclination towards the theoretical aspects of the field. Despite some initial difficulties adjusting to the competitive atmosphere, Robert soon found himself immersed in the world of academia. His love for physics only deepened, and he switched his major to the subject that held an irresistible allure for him. During his undergraduate years, Oppenheimer was introduced to the groundbreaking theories of quantum mechanics and relativity, which were revolutionizing the field of physics. He voraciously devoured the works of Albert Einstein, Niels Bohr, and Werner Heisenberg, among others. These scientific giants inspired him to explore the frontiers of theoretical physics. Upon completing his undergraduate studies, Robert embarked on a journey to Europe, the epicenter of scientific innovation at the time. He attended the University of Cambridge, where he had the privilege of studying under the tutelage of the brilliant physicist J.J. Thomson. In England, Oppenheimer honed his mathematical prowess and developed a deep understanding of quantum theory, an area of physics that would become his lifelong passion. After Cambridge, Oppenheimer ventured to Germany, where he studied at the University of Göttingen, a renowned center for theoretical physics. There, he worked closely with Max Born, a physicist whose guidance further enriched Oppenheimer's knowledge of quantum mechanics. He also became acquainted with luminaries like Werner Heisenberg and Wolfgang Pauli, forging friendships and collaborations that would prove invaluable in his future endeavors. Part 3. The birth of a scientist. Returning to the United States, Oppenheimer earned his PhD in physics from Harvard in 1927. His dissertation on the quantum theory of molecular rotational spectrum was a groundbreaking contribution to the field, earning him acclaim among his peers. It was during this period that he began to establish himself as a promising young physicist with a profound ability to delve into the complexities of theoretical physics. In 1927, Oppenheimer was appointed as an associate professor at the University of California, Berkeley. This marked the beginning of a long and fruitful association with the institution. At Berkeley, he immersed himself in research, working on topics ranging from quantum electrodynamics to neutron-proton interactions. His ability to tackle complex problems with mathematical rigor earned him a reputation as a brilliant and innovative scientist. As the Great Depression swept across the nation, Oppenheimer's career faced challenges. Funding for scientific research dwindled, and job opportunities became scarce. However, his passion for physics remained undiminished. He continued to pursue his research with unwavering determination, often taking on teaching positions to make ends meet. Part 4. World War II and the Atomic Bomb. The outbreak of World War II in 1939 would alter the course of Oppenheimer's life in profound ways. As the war raged in Europe and the Pacific, the scientific community recognized the potential of atomic energy for both destruction and peace. Albert Einstein, himself a refugee from Nazi Germany, penned a letter to President Franklin D. Roosevelt, warning of the possibility of Nazi Germany developing an atomic weapon. This letter catalyzed the establishment of the Manhattan Project, a top-secret research program aimed at developing an atomic bomb before the Axis powers. In 1942, Oppenheimer was recruited to join the Manhattan Project, and he accepted the position of director of the project's Los Alamos Laboratory in New Mexico. The laboratory was tasked with the monumental challenge of designing and building the world's first atomic bomb. Oppenheimer's brilliance, leadership, and organizational skills made him the ideal candidate for this critical role. At Los Alamos, Oppenheimer assembled a team of some of the brightest scientific minds of the era. Physicists, chemists, engineers, and mathematicians worked tirelessly under the tightest security measures to harness the power of the atom. The challenges were immense, but Oppenheimer's visionary leadership and ability to foster collaboration among the scientists drove progress. As the laboratory's director, Oppenheimer faced moral and ethical dilemmas. He was acutely aware of the devastating potential of the weapon they were developing, and he grappled with the implications of unleashing such destructive power. He once remarked, "Now I am become Death, the destroyer of worlds," upon witnessing the first successful test of the atomic bomb. This moment, a quote from the Hindu scripture Bhagavad Gita, captured the profound weight of his responsibility. Part 5, Post-War Years and Struggles. The end of World War II marked a turning point in Oppenheimer's life. The atomic bombs dropped on Hiroshima and Nagasaki brought the war to a swift conclusion, but also ushered in the nuclear age and a new era of global uncertainty. Oppenheimer, who had played a pivotal role in the creation of these devastating weapons, began to advocate for international control of nuclear technology to prevent further proliferation and catastrophe. Despite his wartime accomplishments, Oppenheimer faced scrutiny and suspicion during the early years of the Cold War. His left-leaning political views and associations with left-wing organizations, along with concerns about his security clearance, led to a government investigation. In 1954, he was subjected to a security hearing that ultimately revoked his security clearance, effectively ending his involvement in classified government projects. The loss of his security clearance was a devastating blow to Oppenheimer's career and reputation. He retreated from the public eye, returning to academic life at the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton, New Jersey. Despite the setback, he continued his research and contributed to the field of theoretical physics. Part 6, Legacy and Influence. In the years that followed, Oppenheimer's contributions to science and his advocacy for responsible nuclear policy earned him recognition and respect. He became a vocal advocate for arms control and nuclear disarmament, using his stature as a renowned scientist to influence public opinion and government policies. His efforts helped shape the Partial Test Ban Treaty of 1963, which prohibited nuclear testing in the atmosphere, underwater, and in outer space. Robert Oppenheimer's story is one of brilliance, ambition, moral dilemmas, and the enduring quest for scientific truth. His legacy is a complex one, as he is remembered both as the visionary physicist who led the development of the atomic bomb and as the advocate for peace and responsible use of nuclear technology. His life and work serve as a reminder of the immense power of science and the ethical responsibilities that come with it. In 1967, Robert Oppenheimer passed away, leaving behind a lasting legacy in the annals of science and history. His contributions to physics, his leadership during a critical juncture in human history, and his commitment to the responsible use of scientific knowledge continue to inspire generations of scientists and thinkers. Robert Oppenheimer's story is a testament to the complexity of human endeavors, where brilliant minds grapple with the profound consequences of their creations.